Hi guys, this is Jay Lee. I wanted to go over some footage that Robert Bingham had captured in toward the end of March of 2018. I want to thank Robert Bingham for letting me use some of his footage and able to comment on what I think this thing is. There's, you know, nothing definitive here. Your guess is as good as mine, but I just want to give you my opinion. To me, this thing looks like a giant aerial pyrosome. Some people call it an ebony, but this thing is definitely one of the best I've ever seen captured. Pyrosomes are colonies composed of hundreds and sometimes thousands of individuals known as zooids. They combine together with this stuff called the gelatinous tunic. They've been known to grow about 60 feet long, and they're called by some scientists the unicorns of the sea. Pyro means fire in Greek. These things are bioluminescent. They're fluffy, they eat plankton, and they use like a jet propulsion through fluidity. Their movement is way more elegant than that of similar animals. Although pyrosomes look terrifying, they're actually very, very friendly creatures. Let me tell you what this is not. It's not a released balloon ark. Although I can see people misconstruing that this is some sort of a balloon ark, it's absolutely not. And if you look close enough, you'll see why. I took a frame in the video and measured a couple of individual zooids in pixels. If these were typical latex balloons, they'd be about 12 inches in diameter. This would make this object contain about 5,000 to 7,000 balloons, which is unheard of in the balloon-making community. It would be one of the largest balloon structures ever created, and to be honest, most balloon makers wouldn't touch this with a 10-foot pole. The event that this would be made for would have to be epic. It would take dozens of people hours to put something like this together. And honestly, latex balloons really don't last that long. I'm just saying that there was nothing epic going on Los Angeles on the 23rd of March 2018. Nothing's been seen on the internet. What you are looking at is not man-made. I do agree with Robert Bingham in that I think that this is a biological entity, similar to the pyrosome. Another thing that I think is really incredible with this one, that it seems like it's moving in sequence. It moves in the same way over and over again. When I pulled frames from the video, the frames look very similar, which tells me that it was tumbling in sequence. Yet you can see the movement fluidity. I just wanted to get across that this is a UFO, not a flying saucer, and it's not constructed by man. This is an atmospheric animal and something our scientists have not discovered yet. What is mind-blowing to me is that this thing came to Robert Bingham after he summoned for it to come to his location. So this thing goes a lot farther than what you see. To me, this looks like a giant enclosed sausage. The edges are highly defined and organized with random internal coloring of black, red, and white. It looks to me that the white particles seem to protrude out a lot more than the reddish particles. I find the larger balloon arcs have to maintain extreme structural symmetry, which includes colors. What kind of colors? Usually festive, bright, attention-getting colors. Who would spend $10,000 to $15,000 on an epic balloon structure that looks like a giant sausage? The answer? Nobody. As far as I can tell, never once has a balloon arc been released into the sky. That would be totally environmentally irresponsible. Could it happen? Yes. But you've never seen it on the internet. You've never seen any pictures. Is it possible that they accidentally released this prior to the major event that was just about to happen? Yes, but it's not probable. So Robert Bingham was just in the right place at the right time in order to capture this. Of course, this thing appeared after he called for it. The coincidence of this whole thing would just be astronomical, and you're really reaching for straws if you truly believe that. Anyway, enjoy the rest of the video. There's still a lot of great pictures coming up. This is certainly one of the best giant aerial pyrosomes ever captured on video. So give this one a thumbs up, go check out more videos on Robert Bingham's website, and I'll see you guys next time.